welcome to the Baylor APAC 8th grade promotion ceremony. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the 8th grade class of 2020 on all of their academic achievements during the past 3 years here at Baylor APAC Middle School. I would like you to know that I'm very proud of each and every one of you. I would also like to thank our Baylor parents for their continued support of our students here at Baylor APAC Middle School. Thank you, parents.
Hello, my name is Jamari Sivin. I'm an 8th grader at Baylor APAC, an honor student and a member of the student council. I am happy to bring the greetings to our administrators, teachers, staff, and student body. I welcome each and every one of you to an 8th grade virtual class day. Our theme is, if you're going to live, leave a legacy. So make a mark on the world that can't be erased.
Thompson. It is my pleasure to be chosen to reflect on the memories that we have made here at Baylor APAC. I would like to thank the teachers, administration, classmates, and the others who have helped us along this journey. Middle school has been unforgettable. With that being said, I believe that Baylor APAC has helped us prepare for the future and whatever it may hold. The past 3 years that we have spent here have been very influential and made us who we are today. Starting off in sixth grade, we were nervous but excited for this new chapter. Everything seemed larger than life. The halls were bigger, the students were older, and our classes had quadrupled. Sixth grade was all about adjusting to our new normal. As my mother echoed in my ears about being responsible and balancing classes with life, we ran into my future counselor, Ms. Jones. She also shed light on the fact that this was going to be different, and that we were going to have to develop time management skills. Although sixth graders could not participate in extracurricular activities, we were allowed to run for student council offices. I got the opportunity to run for student council treasurer. Although I did not win, this experience helped me open up, learn how to campaign, and also taught me how to network among my classmates. Toward the end of sixth grade, the girls were given a great opportunity. We were able to try out for cheerleading. The tryouts helped us learn how to handle constructive criticism. Later, I was filled with a mix of emotions when I found out that I had made the team. Transitioning into seventh grade, I was excited because I was a cheerleader. Being on this team made me more confident, taught me how to work with others, and was all around fun. Seventh grade was fun, but there were challenges. The work wasn't hard. If you mix that with the social life and changes of becoming a teenager, it becomes hard. We have to figure out how to balance our grades, friends, and our extracurricular activities. This took some time and hard work, but in the end it paid off. Also in seventh grade, one of our electives was choir. Before seventh grade, I was interested in the vocal program at Power APAC, but when I auditioned, I did not make it. Being in the choir at Bagley helped me to better understand music. It was also a great experience. Later that year, I re-auditioned for vocal and made it. We seventh graders also had another accomplishment that year. We were inducted into the National Junior Honor Society. This was one of our greatest achievements in middle school. In my opinion, seventh grade went by really fast, but we made great memories with our teachers, family, friends, and teammates. With the help and guidance of our teachers, we made it through seventh grade. As eighth grade was approaching, it began to register in my mind that my classmates and I were growing up and about to enter yet another chapter. We had goals we wanted to reach and sports we wanted to play. We had no idea if the work would be hard or easy. But I soon discovered that all we had to do was apply and believe in ourselves. One thing I know for certain is that everyone was looking forward to all the 8th grade end of the year activities, such as the 8th grade trip and ball. These were going to be the highlights of our year. All of us were excited about going to high school, but we needed to finish this year first. This year, I was not a part of the Bailey APAC Knights cheerleading team. Instead, I tried out for two other sports, soccer and volleyball. I made both teams. They were both memorable opportunities that gave me leadership skills, teamwork skills, and allowed me to make new friends. All of my coaches, Mrs. Jones, Mr. DeVille, and Coach Atkins, helped me learn about my sport. This year was my first in the vocal program at Power APAC, and the time that we did have together, we had our Christmas performance and got to perform many solos in class. I felt very welcomed by my Power teachers, and that made my experience even better. For me this year, the work was not hard, but challenging at times. If we ever needed help, we had an amazing set of teachers to help us with our problems and answer all of our questions. Although our 8th grade year was cut short, it was my favorite. Between my teachers and my classmates, I had a great time and made unforgettable memories. They say people only remember the first and forget the rest, but I believe that these last 3 years have been a great life experience. In my opinion, we don't need awards or medals to prove that we have something special within us. All of us have been blessed with talents and are worth congratulating. And as many times as we have imagined this day, I don't think anyone would have imagined it like this. Now that we have passed the challenges of middle school, it's time for us to move on to a bigger fight, high school. The lessons that we have learned in class will help us get through the next stage. We also need to retain the things we learned other than the academic stuff, such as gaining the courage to stand up in front of the class when we can barely work the nerve to talk to the person next to us. Also, having the dedication to complete our math homework when the only thing that we actually know about it is the fact that we have to complete it. Those are but some of the things that we have learned about ourselves that go beyond our textbooks. These are the things that we will need, not only in high school, but even after that. Also, learn to appreciate others because we can't stand on our own. Of course, we can solve problems by ourselves, answer our tests individually, and go through our everyday lives on our own. But no one can deny how important the people are around us. Our parents, friends, teachers, administrators, and even the bus driver, and people who serve us our lunch, all have played a vital role in helping us to be where we are today. More importantly, God has made it possible to see us through all the challenges and come out of them stronger and better. For all those blessings, I, along with the entire 8th grade class, would like to thank every one of you. Once again, congratulations. We deserve to give ourselves one big round of applause.
I would like to take this opportunity to recognize our top 10, number 10, Jordan Edwards. Number 9, Karis McGowan. Number 8, Shania Gatlin. Number 7, Angel Bell. Number 6, Emilion Esco. Number 5, Whitney Jones. Number 4, Joshua Paul Johnson. Number 3, Luz Luna. Number 2, Kamila Cousin. And number 1, Madison Walker. Congratulations to the top 10 at Baylor APAC Middle School 2020. Thank you.
that a hero lies in you.
Class of 2020, we worked like never before. For the last 3 years, we had our focus aimed knocking on promotion's door. Thinking about it, preparing for it, and answering questions. But who knew that we wouldn't even get tested? Our stride, even our shiny knight of armor, was shaken. Our dream was almost taken by one smarter than us all, a pandemic that caused so many we knew and loved to fall. A stealer of dreams and all those other silly little things. The games we liked to play, inside we were now demanded to stay. Away from each other, at times even hesitant to kiss our mothers. Afraid and confused, no longer were we amused to miss any school. We longed to walk the halls, the smell of paper and unsharpened pencils, the sound of the bell and all those unfamiliar cafeteria smells. Our class proved to be like a strong united river. We really do bleed black and silver. Eighth grade class of 2020. Each one of you are here for a reason. Your lives are more important than a grade or a career. The way you have performed through it all shows you have a strong voice and a loving heart. Make noise everywhere you go. Clear the path for those behind you. Acknowledge those in front of you. And more than anything else, thank those who walked alongside you.
think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children so that they know it's a better world for them and think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. Thereby, be the one dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. A love that cannot lie. Love is strong. It only cares for joy, for giving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel, there will drift. We'll stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's enough for us growing. And the one we once believed in will shine again in grace.
challenge to you, the 8th grade class of 2020, never give up on your dreams and always strive for excellence. There will be challenges down the road. Remember to persevere through your challenges and never give up. I would like to say that it was an honor for me to serve as your principal the past 2 years at Baylor APAC Middle School. And remember, we're the best of the best, better than the rest. We are the Baylor Knights. Have a great day.
Good morning, you guys. This is Miss Wells. This morning to the class of Baylor APAC 2020, you have been challenged. You have been challenged to be and become the best person that you can possibly be. You have been challenged to always follow every dream that you dreamed of. You have been challenged to understand that there's nobody exactly like you, and there's nobody that's going to do the things you do the way you do them. Understand that you are an individual, which means there will be times that you have to make individual decisions. Decisions that are best for you. Understand that you are a leader and you are not a follower. We challenge you to listen more and talk less, because when you listen more, you're able to gain so much more knowledge just by listening. We challenge you to believe even when you feel like you don't have the strength to move on further, because you can. You have been equipped with the tools. You have been equipped with everything that you need to be successful in life. The key is, will you use those tools to move to the next level? Will you use those tools to become the best person that you can become? Your teachers here, the 8th grade staff, have always went beyond what they had to do, what they needed to do, and what they wanted to do to help you to become the person you are today. Although there's some situations that have changed the way class day had taken place and won't take place this year, but it does not take away all the memories, all the things you learned, and all the places that you're going to go just because you believe and just because you tried. Y'all, it's going to be a great year. We look forward to hearing great stories and testimonies about how you have become and how you have achieved goals beyond your most highest desires. You've been challenged to become that person that you look into the mirror and you say, I am proud to be me. Once again, class of 2020, we're so proud of you. We're so proud of the things that you've done and the things that you will continue to do. Be strong and know that you are indeed a Baylor Knight. Have a great day.
First, let me start off by saying, Baylor APAC Class of 2020, we did it. I think those three words alone deserve a round of applause. Woo! I am filled with a great deal of pride to stand before you today to give a speech that we've all been looking forward to. Bittersweet expressions that culminate our middle school years. All the studying, quizzes, tests, projects, classwork, and homework, all the sad, funny, and happy times have come to this moment. The moment where we say goodbye to Baylor APAC and hello to high school and new endeavors. Let's reminisce to August 2017, which was most of our first days of middle school in a building that was huge and had many unknown faces. We were nervous and felt a little intimidated. But look at us now. Look at how far we have come. We have learned the routines of middle school and grew accustomed to the workload. We made friends who we will never forget, no matter the different journeys we experienced. Each year brought new memories, and this year, the year of 2020, the year of the health pandemic that allowed us to show and prove that we are strong and responsible individuals who can adapt to change and still be successful. We 8th graders had the awesome opportunity to display accountability and the best that is in each of us. As we embark on our next level of education, please remember everything that we have learned. We will leave Baylor ready to start an unfamiliar yet rewarding path. We are one step closer to the real world. Although we have all looked forward to this day, it is still bittersweet. This is the end of something we are used to, something that was comfortable, and the beginning of something new. There is no way that we have come to this moment without the help of adults who are there for us. Thank you, principal, teachers, and staff, for all you have done to help us prepare for this day. We will truly miss you and will never forget what you guys have engraved in our brains and our hearts. To our parents, families, and friends, we are thankful for everything and are grateful for your sacrifice. As we leave here today, please remember that we will always be a Bailey Knight. We will forever be part of the Bailey family. Let's hope that we have much joy and happiness as we begin a new chapter in our lives. As we say farewells, let's hope that this is not the last goodbye to each other. And if it is, that we will hold on to the memories that we have. And for the last time, we're the best of the best, better than the rest. We are the Bailey Knights.
People drive by, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a ray of hope. joke, worthless inside, left with no fight. But this can't be all, 'cause you still have life. I'm here. Struggle's real, but you can let go, 'cause you're trusted with this fire you're in. We're champions, we will win. I'm here.
These are the moments. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there.
No time.